When Erica Levine was 7½, up to her door came James Medcalf, and he said, "Will you marry me, Erica Levine?" And Erica Levine said, "What do you mean?" "Well, me father and me mother say a fellow ought to marry. Me father says his brother, who is my Uncle Larry, never married. And he says, Uncle Larry is a dope. So will you marry me?" Says Erica, "Nope. My piano teacher's smart, and she never had to marry. Your father may be right about your Uncle Larry, but not being married isn't what made him a dope. Don't ask me again, 'cause me answer is nope." When Erica Levine was 17, she went to the prom with Joe Bernstein, and they danced to the light of the sparkling bobby socks, for the theme of the prom was the history of rock. And after the dance, Joe kissed her at the door, and he says, "Do you know what that kiss was for?" She says, "No, I don't, but you kissed just fine." And he says, "It means that you are mine." And she says, "No, I'm not," and she rushed inside. And on the way home, Joe Bernstein cried, and she cried too, and wrote a letter to Miz, saying, "This much I know, I'm mine, not his." When Erica Levine was 23, her lover said, "Erica, marry me. This relationship is answering a basic need, and I'd like to have it legally guaranteed. For without your precious love, I'd surely die. So why not let's get married?" said Erica. "Why, basic needs at your age should be met by you. I'm your lover, not your mother. Let's be careful what we do. For if ever I will marry, it will be to grow, not for tradition or protection or possession, no. I love you, but your needs are a very different issue." Then he cried, and Erica handed him a tissue. When Erica was 30, she was talking with Lou, discussing and deciding what they wanted to do. "When we get married, should we move into your place or mine? Yours is rent control, mine's on the subway line." And they argued and they talked, and they finally didn't care. They bought an apartment near Harvard Square. Their wedding was a quiet one, they wanted it that way, and they thought a lot about the things that they would choose to say. "I will live with you and love you, but I'll never call you mine." The judge pronounced them married, and everyone had wine. And a happy ever after life is not the kind they got, but they tended to be happy more often than not.